Hello, welcome to a quick video where we will create a piece of Desmos art using the geometry tool. Here, we will be making a fish using arcs, circles, and a reflection transformation. When creating art, the geometry tool offers a point and click interface that gives you plenty of flexibility to explore. To get started on our fish, we will use the line tool to create a horizontal line, which will represent the middle of our reflection. From there, we can switch to the arc tool, which connects any three points with a smooth arc. We can create the body of our fish by clicking a point on our line, then a point above, and then clicking back onto our line. After you've placed an object, you can always go back to the Select tool and drag these points if you want to make any adjustments. Next, let's add a top fin made out of two arcs, coming off the top of our large body arc. For the top half of the tail fin, we will again use two arcs, starting from the back point of the body. We now have the top half of our fish, and we want to reflect these same arcs below our line. To use a transformation, we first need to select the objects we want to transform. To accomplish this in one step, we want to select all of the arcs. By changing to the Box Select option, we can draw boxes to include just the arcs. We can avoid selecting the points to keep our image as clean as possible. Once our five arcs are selected, we click the Transform button in the toolbar, then click Reflect, and finally, the horizontal line that we are reflecting over. After we've performed our transformation, we can still go back and adjust our points and see how both the original and reflected arcs will adjust together. Let's add a bit of character to our fish with another arc to round out our fish's face, as well as a little grin using an arc. Let's switch over to the circle tool, which we can use to create an eye for our fish by clicking a center point and another point on the outside of the circle. We'll also create some circular bubbles to finish up our objects. While this fish is looking delightful already, there are a few options to help polish this up. Whether you're making an academic geometric construction or a work of art, using hidden objects can be a powerful tool. For example, if we want to hide one of our points, we can select it and click the Hide option that appears in the upper toolbar. When we click off the point now, we notice it has disappeared from our graph window. However, hiding is not the same as deleting. That point still exists, and it's still defining those arcs. If we go to the Wrench menu in the top right, we have the option to reveal our hidden objects, which currently is just referring to our newly hidden point. When we check that box, our point reappears, but still slightly more transparent than the neighboring objects, indicating it is still classified as a hidden object. While a hidden object is revealed using this checkbox option, we can make adjustments to it as needed, before deselecting that option from the menu and seeing the object disappear again. Looking at this picture, we see lots of points to hide to clean it up. In fact, we have more points than arcs. In this case, one strategy is to hide everything first, which we can quickly accomplish using Box Select. While this may seem counterintuitive, remember that we didn't just delete those objects, and we can still see them by checking the Reveal checkbox. Now, it's a bit less tedious to go back through and select all the hidden arcs that we want to keep, along with one of these points for our fish's eye. Once we have them all selected, now we see the option to Show All, bringing them back as visible objects. Now when we turn off the Reveal box, we're left with our clean, final product. You can find more strategies for geometry or other tools at the Desmos Help Center. We can't wait to see what you create next.